Yes class, good morning. Today we'll discuss your problem solving exercise 2.1. Theoretical portion has been completed in last lecture. Today we'll discuss problem solving exercise 2.1. The first question has been completed in last lecture. Today we'll discuss your question number second. Question number second here, write the coefficient of x square, in each of the following. So what is the coefficient of the x square? So how to define this coefficient of the x square? Suppose question given coefficient of the x square, yeah, coefficient of the x, coefficient of the x cube, yeah, coefficient of the constant terms. But then method will be same, per variable will be different techniques. So then question number second will solve here. First part of this. Question here, 2 plus x square plus x. Then you will write here coefficient of x, the short form of this coefficient. This one is the short form of the coefficient, COFFI, coefficient of x square. Then you can write answer. What is the coefficient of the x square here? You will write, make the arrow here. X square coefficient here 1, then you write here 1. This is your answer. Suppose you write coefficient of x, then what is the coefficient of the x square? Here multiple is 1, then you can write here 1. But here coefficient of the here write x, then you write coefficient of x here 3, then you will write your answer 3. Clear? Second part. What is the second part here? Okay, minus 2 minus x square, suppose question in this form, plus x cube. So how to write answer here? You will write answer coefficient of x square. First we check the coefficient of the x square terms here. This one the minus 1. The answer here comes minus 1. And suppose question right here, put x square plus 4, your x cube, you write same answer here, x cube. So then you write answer here, coefficient of x cube equal is 1. Because coefficient of x cube here, what is the multiple of the x cube here? 1. Well, no any number here, you will consider here 1. Suppose no any number here, then you will be consider here 1. Here you write the coefficient of the x square. What is the coefficient of x square here? This one is the minus 1. So you write answer here minus 1. Here coefficient of x square, here coefficient, coefficient of x here 3. Then you write answer here 3. In this question, coefficient of the x square, what is the coefficient of x square? No any number here, then you write here 1. Same things here, third part. Third part question here, pi by 2 x square plus x. Then you will write here coefficient of x square. So you check this coefficient of the x square here, pi by 2. Multiple of the pi x square. So here pi by 2, you will write right answer pi by 2. This is your answer. Suppose question here write pi by 2 x square plus x, then you will write here coefficient of x. So coefficient of x you write here, then you write coefficient of multiple here 1, then you write answer is 1. This is your answer. According to you, according to every step, every variable, every terms, how to find out the coefficient here according to this. What things are required here? What things are required here? You will check these terms. Which term of coefficient you find here? X square, x cube, x, any term. Here x square, here x cube. So which term you find the coefficient here? You will be check these terms. According to this, you find the answer. Yes, note down it, then next question.
यस स्टूडेंट, नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर सेकंड इज कंप्लीटेड, देन स्टार्ट दी क्वेश्चन नंबर थर्ड. तो क्वेश्चन, व्हाट इज द क्वेश्चन नंबर थर्ड हियर? गिव वन एग्जांपल ऑफ अ बायनोमियल ऑफ डिग्री 35. मीन्स यू विल बी गिव द वन एग्जांपल ऑफ द अ बायनोमियल व्हिच हैविंग द डिग्री ऑफ 35. एंड सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन हियर, अ मोनोमियल ऑफ डिग्रीज 100. यू विल बी गिव द टू एग्जांपल हियर. फर्स्ट अ बायनोमियल व्हिच हैविंग द डिग्री 35 एंड अ मोनोमियल व्हिच हैविंग द डिग्री ऑफ 100. तो यू नो दी व्हाट इज द डिग्री, हाईएस्ट पावर ऑफ द एक्सप्रेशन या पॉलिनोमियल, हाईएस्ट पावर ऑफ द पॉलिनोमियल इज कॉल्ड द डिग्री. हाईएस्ट पावर ऑफ द पॉलिनोमियल इज कॉल्ड द डिग्री. नाउ लुक हियर, फर्स्ट हियर क्वेश्चन नंबर थर्ड, फर्स्ट पार्ट हियर यू विल राइट हियर द बायनोमियल फॉर्म. तो नाउ यू कैन राइट द एक्स हैविंग 30 पावर डिग्री प्लस 2. दिस इज द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ, बिकॉज द हाइएस्ट पावर ऑफ दिस, यू कैन राइट दी, यू विल राइट ओनली द बायनोमियल फॉर्म. यू कैन राइट हियर सपोज 3x7. तो दिस इज द बायनोमियल फॉर्म. या यू कैन राइट दिस फॉर्म कि एक्स 35 प्लस 7. दिस इज ऑल्सो, दिस इज द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ द बायनोमियल व्हिच हैविंग द डिग्री इज 35. सेकेंड एग्जाम्पल, नाउ सेकेंड एग्जाम्पल वाई 100 ओनली मोनोमियल फॉर्म. तो वाई 100, अदरवाइज यू कैन राइट वाई 100 अपॉन 5. अदरवाइज यू कैन राइट वाई 100 3y. दीज आर द टर्म्स ऑफ द मोनोमियर. मीन्स दिस वन द वन टर्म्स, दिस वन इज द वन टर्म, दिस वन इज द वन टर्म्स. और दिस इज द टू टर्म, दिस इज द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ द बायनोमियल फॉर्म और दिस इज द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ द मोनोमियल फॉर्म. मीन्स मोनोमियल हैविंग द वन टर्म्स बट डिग्री इज द 100. But binomial having the two terms, so this is the degree here. Given condition the having the degree, highest power is the 35. According to this, you can make the example of the having the degree is 20, having the degree is 50, having the degree is 100, 200, 300. This is not matter. Means highest power of the polynomial here, according to given condition, what condition is required? Yes, that questions. Yes, note down it, then next. Yes, student, next question here. Question number third is completed. Then question number fourth. What is the question number fourth here? Write the degree of each of the following polynomials. So now look the question number fourth on book and check every question's highest power of the polynomial. So you check the highest power of the polynomial. This one is called the degree. So in first part here, 5x³ plus 4x² plus 7x. So what is the highest power here in this term? The 5x³. So this is your, means degree here 3. How to write the answer here? Very simple method. So question number 4 is first part. 5x exponent 3 plus 4x² plus 7x. What is the degree of this? You will write here the degree. What is the degree? Highest power is the polynomial, degree or 3. According to this pattern, you will write the answer. What is the highest power of the polynomial? The highest power here 3. The degree is 3. According to this, in second part here, highest power is 2. So then you will write the answer, degree is 2. Then third part, 5t minus root 7. The highest power is 1. Then degree will be here 1. Next, in fourth part, highest power, only in fourth part, you look in fourth part here, you only write here constant number. So what is the degree of this? The degree here 0. How it is possible? Suppose you write the 3 into x exponent 0. You know the value of the x exponent 0 is 1. Means 3 into 1 equal to 3. So you can write the 3 exponent 0, value of the x exponent 0 is 1. So means x exponent 0. What is the exponent of, what is the highest power of this 0? So means suppose any constant number given here, then you will be write the degree here 0. How is possible? According this way. Means value of the x exponent 0 is 1. The 3 into 1 equal to 3. So you can write the one place is x exponent 0. So then x exponent 0, the degree of this constant number is 0. Clear? Yeah, yes, note down. Then next question here. Yes, student, next question, question number 5th here. Question number 5th. Very simple question of this. Question number 5th here, classify the following as linear equation, quadratic and cubic polynomial. Yeah, linear polynomial, quadratic polynomial and cubic polynomial. So you will classify the, that which polynomial here linear, which polynomial here quadratic, or which polynomial here cubic polynomial. And then first part here x square plus x, second part here x minus x cube, third part here y plus y exponent 2 plus 4, and fourth part here 1 plus x, and fifth part here 3t, and sixth part here t square, and seventh part here 7x cube. So all part I am writing here, all part here. So how to define this, which part here polynomial, which polynomial of this linear, cubic and linear, cubic and quadratic. You will don't check here the terms here, you will check only here highest power. You know, suppose any polynomial having the one power, highest power is one, this one is called the linear polynomial. Second thing, suppose any polynomial having the highest power is 2, then this one is called the quadratic polynomial. Third thing, suppose any polynomial having the 3 power, then this one is called the cubic polynomial. Or suppose any polynomial having the highest power is the 4, then this one is called the biquadratic polynomial. According these rules, you will be checked questions. See which type example given here, which type example given here, in which type polynomial here. So suppose you keep the mind in these things. Suppose having the 1 power, this one is called the linear. Suppose having the 2 power, highest degree, highest power. Highest degree. Suppose having the second the quadratic, and 3 is called here cubic. Here only example here, highest power here 2. This one is the example of the quadratic. Quadratic polynomial. This one is the quadratic polynomial. Second example here. Yes, then highest power here. Highest power is the one here. This one is called the linear. The here highest power here 2. The means highest power here the 2. This is called the quadratic polynomial. And this one, according to you, write this one. Suppose highest power here 3. Highest power here 3. Then you can write this cubic polynomial. Cubic polynomial. And here highest power here 2, that means quadratic polynomial. Quadratic polynomial. Next, here highest power here 1. Now look, this is the constant term, but this is the highest power here 1. So this is called the linear. According to this, linear. I-N-E-R, linear polynomial. And here highest power same here 1, then this is also the linear. linear polynomial, or here highest power here 2, so then this one is called the quadratic polynomial. And this you have the highest power here 3, the highest power here 3, then you can write the cubic polynomial. This one is the cubic polynomial. And suppose highest power here 4, then this one called the biquadratic. This one is called the biquadratic. The highest power is any polynomial having the highest power 1. The name of this polynomial is a linear polynomial. Second thing, highest power, yeah, highest degree, yeah, highest exponent, anything say you. Highest degree, you can say highest degree, yeah, highest power, yeah, highest exponent. This is not matter. If 2, then you can say the quadratic polynomial. And if it's highest degree, yeah, highest exponent, yeah, 3, then you can say name of this the cubic polynomial. Or highest degree is 4, then you can say name of this polynomial is biquadratic. According to your example, name of this polynomial here, power 2, the quadratic, power 3, cubic, power 2, quadratic, power 1 here, linear, power 1 here, linear, power 2 here, quadratic, and power 3 here, cubic. So you note down this. The next question. Yes, student, next point we will discuss here, zeros of a polynomial. What is the zeros of the polynomial? What is the value of the polynomial? Both things are different here, zeros and values. Which value, suppose you are putting any point on the polynomial, a result comes as the zero, then this is called the zeros of the polynomial. What do you mean of the zeros? This means roots of the polynomial. This one is the roots of the polynomial. Second things, suppose you are putting any value of the zeros, polynomials, a result is not come to zero, so it means this is the only general value of the polynomial, not zeros of the polynomial, not roots of the polynomial. Second thing, okay, how many zeros of a polynomial? Suppose any polynomial given, then you how to decide it, okay, how many zeros of the given polynomial here, then you will check the exponent of the zero, exponent of the polynomials. Suppose exponent means degree. Suppose 1 degree, then 1 zero. Suppose 2 degree, then 2 zero. Suppose 3 degree, then 3 zero. Suppose 4 degree, then 4 zero. According this rule, you will find the zero here. So every linear polynomial having the 1 zero, every quadratic polynomial having the 2 zeros, every cubic polynomial having the 3 zeros, and every biquadratic polynomial having the 4 zeros. So zeros means roots of the polynomial. So now first I will discuss here, okay, suppose any example, the zeros of a polynomial. Zeros of a polynomial. Zero of polynomial. Suppose you will write here Px equal to 5x cube minus 2x square plus 3x minus 2. This polynomial given here, then first of all, okay, how many zeros of this polynomial? How many roots of this polynomial? So what is the highest power here? Highest power here 3 means highest degree here 3, this polynomial, then you can say in this polynomial is 0 is 3 0. Second things, suppose you are which values of zeros of this polynomial? Suppose you are putting the value of x equal to 1. Suppose you are putting the value x equal to 1. Suppose you are putting the value x equal to 1 here. Then what result come here? Now check. 5 q of the 1 minus 2 q of the square plus 3 into 1 minus 2. Now check, so this 5 into 1, 5 into 5, q of the 1. Suppose here you are having the q of the 1 equal to 1. Suppose q of the square equal to 1. This is not matter, how many power of the 1 here. So 2 into 1 plus 3, 1 into 3 and minus 2. Then you 5 minus 2 plus 3 minus plus 2. So you don't. This is not cancelled. 5 or 3, 8, minus 4, plus 5 or plus 3, not just plus 5 or plus 3, plus 8,
minus 2 or minus 2 here, result come here, minus 4. Then what result come here? Plus 4. So suppose you are, means this is the value of the polynomial at x equal to 1, the result is 4. The 4 is not zeros of this, 4 is not zeros of the given polynomial. 4 is the value of the polynomial at x equal to 1. So this polynomial having the value at x equal to 1 is 4. That is not, it means what is the value of this polynomial at the point x equal to 1 is 4. But what is the zeros of this? Suppose you are putting any value here, suppose you are putting x equal to 1, a result come here 0, then you can say that this value is the zeros of the polynomial. Which value? Those value having the value, those value giving the result is 0, then you can say that this value is the zeros of the polynomial. Second example, I will put here second example. Suppose you are putting here minus 1. What means you putting here? Minus 1. Then check this, x equal to 1 is not zeros of this. But then you are now put x equal to minus 1. So p minus 1, 5 is minus 1 is cube. This one is a cube. Minus 2 is minus 1 is square. Plus 3 into minus 1 and minus 2. So what does that come here? 5 into minus 1. Suppose you will be do 1 cube of the minus 1 is equal to minus 1. Because negative number having the odd power, the result here come negative. Suppose any negative number having the even power, this one the positive. According to this rule, every negative number having the odd power, the result here come is negative. Or every negative number having the exponent is even number, the result come here the positive form. This one is the positive form. According to this rule. So this minus 3 cube here, the minus 1 and minus 2 into 1 plus 3 plus 3 minus 3 is plus minus minus and minus 2. So minus 5 minus 2 minus 2 and minus 3 and minus minus 5. The result here minus 10 minus 2. The result here come here minus 12. So this is also is not the, because when you put in the values minus 1, the result come here minus 12. So minus 12 is not zeros. Minus 12 is the value of this polynomial at the value of the this polynomial at minus at x equal to minus 1, result minus 12. So this is not zero. Then I will take next one example. Then note down first it. Yes, student. First example I have solved here. But in this example, we have not got the zeros of the polynomial. You have got the value of the polynomial at x equal to 1 and at x equal to minus 1. Suppose, second example here, suppose px equal to x square minus 3x plus 2. Suppose your next example here this, and you will find the value of at x equal to 1. What value of the p when equal to 1 square, this is the square of the 1 square minus 3 into 1 plus 2. What result come here? Minus 3 plus 2 and 3. So plus 3 and minus 3 result here come 0. Now look here. You will check this. This polynomial having the degree is 2. Listen carefully. This polynomial is a quadratic polynomial. So it means this polynomial having the two zeros. The first zero you are at x equal to 1. Because you are when you putting the value x equal to 1 in this polynomial, the result here comes 0. You can say that x equal to 1 is the zeros of the given polynomial. Because result here comes 0 when you putting the x equal to 1 in given polynomial. So then this value is called here zeros of the polynomial. It is clear, this is the first zero, this one is the first zero. So what is the second zero of this polynomial? What is the second zero of the polynomial? Then you will find in there, how to find out the second zero of the polynomial here. You can find the two techniques of the find of the zero of, yeah, roots of the polynomial. Here are two, first is the spreading middle terms methods, second here in this method.
So first you note down this. So how to find out this second zeros of the polynomial here? First note down it. So this one you have the first zero. What is the, suppose you are putting at x equal to 2. Suppose you are putting x equal to 2 in this polynomial. In this polynomial, what will you come here? X square minus 3 into 2 plus 2. Sorry, this is square of the 2. Square of the 2 here 4 minus value. This value you are putting in this polynomial. This given polynomial you are this. So x place you are putting the 2, square of the 2, 3 into 2 and plus 2. So 3 is the 6 plus 2. So 4 plus 2, 6 minus 6, result here comes 0. The second zero of this polynomial. You can say that x equal to 1 and x equal to 2 are two zeros. How many zeros here? Two zeros. Because polynomial having the power here 2. Second trick, second method of two zero, how to find out the zero here? X square minus 3x plus 2 equal to 0. You are finding your zeros, then you will put here equal to 0. You will making the two, you will factorize of the, this standard form of C here. You will make the two factor here of the two, you will make it the so 2 into 2, 2 into 1 equal to 2 and 2 plus 1 equal to 3. So then this is the trick here, the x square minus 2 plus 1, because you write here 2 plus 1. Means factorize of this 3. 2 into 2 and 2 plus 1 is 3. And if 2 into is 2, making this, when you multiplying the factor, the result comes in the C, or when you adding the factor, then comes in the B. So this is the standard form here, the AX square plus BX plus C equal to 0. This is standard form of the quadratic equations. And plus 2 equal to 0. After that, x square minus 2x minus x plus 2 equal to 0. So taking x common here, x minus 2. Taking common one here, x minus 2 equal to 0. So again taking x minus 2 or x minus 1 equal to 0. Now you check this. When? What value of the x here? So x value of the x equal to 2 or 1. So means your result you are finding in this method, otherwise finding in this method, result will be always coming the same. That means having this polynomial having the two roots, any two zeros, you can say a roots, you can say a root, both things are same. But you can say this polynomial, yeah, this equation having the two roots. Which roots of this? 2 and 1. Suppose you are finding in this technique, the result come here x equal to 1, x equal to 2. That is, that means those, suppose you are putting this 2 here, when you are putting the polynomial value here 1, result will come 0. When you are putting this, putting the value of 2 here, result come here 0. So only 2 number here, those having the result here 0. Yes, you note down then next.